How long were the Israelites in Egypt? In Exodus 12:40, it says, Now the length of time the Israelite people lived in Egypt was 430 years. And so because of this, movies like The Ten Commandments will say things like this.
That's a hard dance you do, old man. We've been dancing it for 400 years.
400 years we've waited.
400 years in bondage, and today he won't move.
After 400 years of slavery.
And experts on the topic will say things like this.
The Israelites were there 430 years. We have the record in the Bible that tells about the Israelites going into Egypt and living there for 430 years.
But if you do the math, you'll find that this is not mathematically possible. You see, Moses was 80 years old when they left Egypt. His father Amram lived to 137. His father Kohath lived to 133. And Kohath was one of the 66 persons who went with Jacob down into Egypt. Now let's just stretch this out as much as we possibly can. Let's assume that Kohath was a newborn baby when he arrived in Egypt. Let's assume that Amram was born the year that his father died, and let's assume that Moses was born the year that his father died. So take 133 plus 137 plus 80, and that equals 350, which means that the amount of time the Israelites were in Egypt could have been no longer than 350 years maximum. Now more than likely Kohath was probably not a newborn baby when he arrived in Egypt. More than likely, Moses was not born the year that his father died, and more than likely, Amram was not born the year that his father died, which means that the amount of time the Israelites were in Egypt would have been significantly less than 350 years. So why does Exodus 12:40 say the Israelites were in Egypt for 430 years when this is not mathematically possible? The key is found in one of Paul's letters. In Galatians 3:16 and 17, Paul says, Now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made, And this I say, that the law, which was 430 years later, cannot annul the covenant that was confirmed before by God in Christ. Basically, Paul is saying that from the time that Abraham received the promise to the time that Moses received the law, there was 430 years. Well, Abraham received the promise when he entered Canaan when he was 75 years old. Then, 25 years later, when Abraham was 100 years old, that's when Isaac was born. Then, 60 years later, when Isaac was 60 years old, that's when Jacob was born. Then, 130 years later, when Jacob was 130 years old, that's when all of Israel arrived in Egypt. So take 25 plus 60 plus 130, and that equals 215, which means that there was 215 years from the time that Abraham entered Canaan to the time that all of Israel arrived in Egypt. Now, Moses received the law the same time that they left Egypt, because remember, the Israelites were living in Goshen, and then Moses led them out of Goshen, brought them through the wilderness, and brought them to the sea. And then God split the waters of the sea in half and brought them into Midian, which is in Arabia, then brought them to Mount Sinai, which is where Moses received the law. And so Moses received the law the same time they left Egypt. So Paul is saying that there was 430 years from this point to this point, and according to the Old Testament, there's 215 years from this point to this point. So take 430 years and then subtract 215 years, and that equals 215, which means that the amount of time that the Israelites were in Egypt was 215 years. 215 in Egypt, 215 in Canaan, 430 total. Now that is mathematically possible, because 215 is significantly less than 350, and that's exactly what the Greek Septuagint says in Exodus 12:40. It says, And the sojourning of the children of Israel while they sojourn in the land of Egypt and the land of Canaan was 430 years. The Samaritan Pentateuch says the same thing. It says, Now the sojourning of the children of Israel and of their fathers, which they had dwelt in the land of Canaan and in Egypt was 430 years. Flavius Josephus says they left Egypt 430 years after our forefather Abraham came into Canaan, but 215 years only after Jacob removed into Egypt. Flavius Josephus is saying the exact same thing. He's saying they left Egypt 430 years since our forefather Abraham came into Canaan, but 215 years only since Jacob removed into Egypt. Flavius Josephus is saying the exact same thing. So why do modern translations say that the Israelites were in Egypt for 430 years when this is not mathematically possible? The reason why is because modern translations like the New King James, the NIV, the NASB, these are all translated from the Hebrew Masoretic text. But the Hebrew Masoretic text is not the original Hebrew text. The copy of the Masoretic text that most modern translations are translated from is called the Leningrad Codex, which was copied in the 11th century AD. But the Greek Septuagint was translated more than 1,000 years before that in 250 BC, which means that the Greek Septuagint would not have been translated from the Hebrew Masoretic, but rather it would have been translated from a much older copy of the Hebrew that's no longer around today. The Samaritan Pentateuch also predates the Masoretic text and would also have been translated from a much older copy of the Hebrew. Flavius Josephus was a first century Jewish historian. He lived long before the Masoretic text was copied, and Josephus had access to ancient Hebrew texts that have since been lost or destroyed. Paul the Apostle lived long before the Masoretic text was copied, and Paul knew Hebrew. In Acts 26, when Paul talks about his encounter with Jesus on the road to Damascus, he says that Jesus spoke to him in the Hebrew language, and Paul understood him. Paul knew Hebrew, and so Paul would also have studied from a much older copy of the Hebrew. And what Paul says in Galatians 3:16 and 17 is consistent with the Greek Septuagint, the Samaritan Pentateuch, and the writings of Flavius Josephus. Now the Bible says, by the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word shall be established. Well, we've got more than two or three witnesses here. We've got four witnesses, all bearing witness that the original Hebrew text said that the Israelites will be in Egypt and Canaan for 430 years. But more than 1,000 years later, when the Hebrew Masoretic text was copied, the phrase "and Canaan" was dropped out of the text, and all of our Bibles are translated from this corrupted copy of the Hebrew. The New King James, the Old King James, the NIV, the NASB, the ESV. If you go to BibleGateway.com, you'll find there's 50 English translations of the Bible on this website, and every single one of them say that the Israelites were in Egypt for 430 years, which is incorrect and mathematically impossible. Every single one of these translations are inconsistent with the original Hebrew, because they're all translated from the Hebrew Masoretic, and according to these four witnesses, the Masoretic text copied it incorrectly. As a matter of fact, these ages of Moses and his father and grandfather are recorded in the Masoretic text, and yet they only add up to 350 years maximum. So in that sense, there's even a fifth witness. The Masoretic bears witness against itself. And so the amount of time the Israelites were in Egypt was only 215 years. But the years of slavery was even less than that, because the Israelites did not become slaves until after Joseph and all that generation died, and then a new king arose who did not know Joseph. Well, Joseph was 30 years old when he entered Pharaoh's service. Then shortly after, there were 7 years of abundance, and then 7 years of famine. So it would appear that after the 7 years of abundance, Joseph would have been 37 years old. Then 2 years into the famine, when he was 39, that's when all of Israel arrived in Egypt. So based on the information given, it appears as if Joseph was 39 years old at the beginning of that 215 years. Then Joseph died at 110. So take 110 and subtract 39, and that equals 71, which means that for 71 years, the Israelites were in Egypt under Joseph's rule, and they were not slaves during those 71 years. So take the 215 years that the Israelites were in Egypt, subtract the 71 years that Joseph was in power, and that equals 144, which means that the Israelites were not slaves for any longer than 144 years maximum. Now Moses was 80 years old when they left Egypt, and they were already in slavery when Moses was born, which means that they could not have been slaves for any less than 80 years minimum. So take the 215 years that the Israelites were in Egypt, subtract the 71 years that Joseph was in power, subtract the 80 years of Moses' life, and that equals 64, which means that there were 64 years in between Joseph's death and Moses' birth. The Israelites became slaves sometime after Joseph died and sometime before Moses was born, sometime within that 64-year time period. Now let's just assume that the Israelites became slaves at exactly the midpoint in between Joseph's death and Moses' birth. That would be 32 years after Joseph died and 32 years before Moses was born. If this is the case, then that would mean that the Israelites were slaves for 112 years. And so the amount of time the Israelites were in slavery was probably about 112 years or so. Maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less, but definitely no more than a maximum of 144, and definitely no less than 80 years minimum. Whatever the case, the Israelites were definitely not slaves for nearly as long as the movies make it sound when they say,
400 years in bondage, and today he won't move!
The Israelites were not slaves for 400 years. They were only slaves for about 112 years or so, plus or minus 32 years. But doesn't Genesis 15:13 say that they'll be enslaved 400 years? No, it doesn't. It says they'll be enslaved and mistreated 400 years. You see, Genesis 15 does not say the Israelites will be enslaved in Egypt 400 years. It says Abraham's seed will be enslaved and mistreated in a land not their own 400 years. Canaan was a land not their own. Egypt was a land not their own. Isaac was Abraham's seed. Jacob was Abraham's seed. The multitudes in Egypt were Abraham's seed. Isaac was mistreated in Canaan. Genesis says that Ishmael, the son of Hagar, was scoffing at Isaac. Paul says in Galatians that the son who was born according to the flesh, who was Ishmael, persecuted the son who was born according to the spirit, who was Isaac. Paul says that Ishmael persecuted Isaac. So Isaac, Abraham's seed, was persecuted or mistreated in Canaan, a land not his own. Abraham's seed was mistreated in a land not his own. From the time that Abraham received the promise to the time that Moses received the law, there was 430 years according to Galatians 3:17. 25 years after Abraham received the promise, that's when Isaac was born. That takes it down to 405 years. Now Genesis says that Ishmael scoffed at Isaac on the same day that Isaac was weaned. Well, according to the Jewish Agency for Israel, in Talmudic times, it was the custom to celebrate the child's weaning any time from 18 months to 5 years. It goes on to say that according to Rabbi Joshua, a child should be allowed to nurse up to the age of 5. Well, if Isaac was weaned at 5 years of age, and Ishmael began to persecute Isaac on the same day that Isaac was weaned, then that would take it down to exactly 400 years. Abraham's seed was mistreated in Canaan. Abraham's seed was mistreated in Egypt. Abraham's seed was enslaved in Egypt. Abraham's seed was enslaved and mistreated in a land not their own 400 years. You see, when you take the prophecy in Genesis and you match that up with the timeline in Exodus, then you're able to understand how these puzzle pieces fit together. But the main thing that causes people to misinterpret this prophecy in Genesis is the Hebrew Masoretic text has dropped the phrase "and Canaan" out of the text. This is the main thing that causes people to believe that the Israelites were in Egypt for 430 years. But the truth is, they were in Egypt for only half that time, for 215 years. According to the documentary Patterns of Evidence, The Exodus, the Israelites' arrival in Egypt was around 1665 BC, and the Exodus took place at about 1450 BC. This means that the Israelites were in Egypt for 215 years. This is the only thing that the archaeological evidence supports. The evidence does not support 430 years in Egypt. This is the reason why it's important to understand biblical history correctly first, in order to correctly understand how it correlates with Egyptian history and archaeology.